guys. Last episode we left Darwin and headed south towards Mataranka. Checked out all the hot springs there, Bitter Springs and Mataranka thermal pools. The next day we trekked our way down to Daly Waters historic pub there. Place was cool. Now in this episode, we had a last minute call on what we were going to do in terms of our travel. Our original plans were to head back down to South Australia, stop in Alice Springs and Coomoopedi, obviously check out Uluru, but instead we did the last minute decision to head for Queensland, pretty much spend the rest of our trip on the east coast before heading back home to Victoria. So, in this episode, onto the Stuart Highway we go, with a quick stop at Elliot, a little indigenous town halfway between Darwin and Alice Springs.
Feeling at the river's edge and tempting, all the steps to follow closer right behind. Is it only when you feel the pot is empty?
Righto, so we've been traveling for about an hour and a half now from Daly Waters. We are currently in Elliot, just a quick stop. So this has to print out a couple of documents for us in order for us to cross our Queensland border.
So I've been frantically searching for somewhere to print our passes this morning, and we've gone into the Elliot Australia Post / grocery store / servo, I think.
Yeah.
And the lady behind the counter told me no, they don't print stuff, so I'd have to go to the library, which was going to be closed for an hour over lunch. So anyway, we come out, we weren't going to print the passes. RJ decided to go in to get a drink, and look what come out printed.
I use my looks, my good looks, my smile, and that's all it takes.
RJ's used his nationality to get us what we want.
She was Filipino, so.
It worked to our advantage. We got the passes printed, and no need to stress about the passes for the Queensland border. You did.
Yeah.
Anyway, win-win. It's a good day.
So did what I had to do there. Now off to Tenant Creek. When you're traveling, you heavily rely on reviews and advice from your fellow travelers. When you hear stories like caravan and cars get broken into, lock up your stuff. If you've never been to that place, it makes you think about that place in a negative way. So we just finished setting up at the caravan park.
So we've been told by the caravan park to make sure everything stays locked up. But we've conquered Fitzroy Crossing, so you know.
So far so good. Didn't have to pull my gun out.
Okay.
This gun. Tenant Creek.
Apparently a temporary IGA.
So yeah, there
I don't
you
know
go.
What happens to the other one.
Look at everything here. It's pretty... Shapes. That's cool. Yeah, how'd you go?
Yeah, good. Very busy in there. So we're heading back to the caravan car. They close the gates at 6:30 p.m. until 6:30 a.m. So we got codes obviously to get in and out, but I don't think it's the kind of place that you want to go out of at night. So
we got
Miller, Marley got shaped, so he's a bit excited. But as you can see behind us, the barbed wire fencing. So yeah, back to the caravan tonight, and then we'll leave in the morning and head towards Queensland border.
So we are just heading towards Queensland. We're gonna head off and do another 400-500 k's today, I think.
Oh well, we've had showers. Mummy come back over and noticed a police car about 50 meters away, so we don't know what happened, but
yeah.
Interesting. Let's go.
What?
It's two
podcasts. Whoa, what's happening here?
Yeah.
So it turned out.
Wowie.
The cabin behind us.
Like literally probably what, 20 metres?
Yeah. They got their car broken into. So you got their eski stolen.
Yeah, sink cab you, and their whole front driver's side is like shattered, gone. So I didn't hear anything. I was up till 3 a.m. and I heard people and whatever, just in general, but I didn't hear any eventful things. So we're leaving Tenant Creek. Seems as though it's all cracked up to be. Almost cracked up to be.
Well, Tenant Creek certainly lived up to its reputation. Before we took the drive across towards Queensland border, we checked out what we thought the worst reviewed roadhouse we've ever come across. Three ways roadhouse.
The reviews are just horrible, so I'm not even keen to go and spend a couple of dollars in there purely for the fact that apparently the owners are quite rude and it's a rip-off and rest.
I'm just pretty keen to go in and suss it out. I know when you travel you rely on the reviews and all that stuff, but yeah, I wouldn't mind having a look and see it for myself and see how good it is, how bad it is.
It's probably the worst reviews that I've come across on Wiki so far.
Yeah.
In regards to any place that we've been to, this is the one that is has constantly got negative reviews.
That pie in there. Can I get two of those, the red and white stickers there, please? Yep, thank you. Thank you.
Mega bread.
Mega bread pie. That's the only pie they had.
Oh, your experience.
I walked in, we looked around, and there's no drivers. I got a pie, got two stickers for the kids' books. No drivers.
Well, there you go, Three Ways Roadhouse. You gotta go see for yourself. Now, we're onto the Barclay Highway. It was gonna be a long day. I couldn't help myself but to just have a little bit of fun. Then we went to the Barclay homestead for a quick rest and lunch, just to break the long day. So this is a quick stop here at Barclay homestead. I'm just gonna have lunch before we keep going. What have we got here?
It's a fly.
You
have a fly slot? Yeah. How much easier would that be? Yeah. Or a tickler, vanilla.
We were going to stay here for one night, weren't we?
Yeah, we were supposed to stay last night here, but we only made it as far as Tenant Creek, and this is beautiful.
Lawns are pretty well looked after.
Yeah, it looks really like very neat and tidy. So
I think if you're coming across to Queensland or even going into NT, you can stop over here.
Next time.
Barclay Homestead Caravan Park, that's where it is. Look at this. And then we can see the background. The grass are amazing. Suits my wife. Alright, so quick stop. That storm over there and the storm we're about to head to, I reckon they're going to merge into one super big
storm. And I was just going to make the kids something to eat and we're going to do the rest in the car because we need to go.
Yeah, there it is. Did not look good at all.
Thank you.
Thank God you got all your passes. How many are in the car? Three? Four?
Including a littly.
Littly? Okay. Oh, I'll just grab those off you for a sec.
Yep. I know they're kind of a little bit hazy, but.
Yeah, that's all right.
We got there. What a day to be out, hey?
Yeah.
Curler.
All right. I'll just give you those. Just sit tight for a sec.
Yep.
We got through the border and it was getting late. This happened.
So finally, the storm caught us. Yeah, what do you reckon?
We just made a run for it.
This. Oh, look at the trees. It's crazy, isn't it?
Where is that?
Sunny Queensland. Perfect.
Welcome.
Well, we certainly copped that one on the head. Welcome to sunny Queensland, they say. Well, the storm only lasted about 20 minutes, wind passed, and we're all good. So the next day we headed for Mount Isa. So that'll be in the next episode. Make sure you subscribe, like, and hit that notification bell so you can be notified for our next video. And that's it for us, and that's it for me. Peace out.